Quick call and response. When I say MBAD, you say MBAD. MBAD. MBAD.
MBAD.
When I say culture by design, you say culture by design. Culture by design.
Culture by design.
Introducing Dabls.
Thanks, Bryce. Our program started a little different than anything else in America. We have a desert when it comes to the history or culture of African people. So we decided to build a museum that would address those issues. Some of the issues deal with knowledge of self. And so we decided to build an exhibit that would appeal to pretty much all people on the planet, because the research say that we are one. So my goal was to prove if we were one. If that meant if I did something that was based in the African culture, it should appeal to everyone on the planet, which it did. We have visitors, more visitors coming from all over the world than local. We have been featured in all kinds of publications, and we did use our space for revitalization, but there was a twist. We chose to put installations where normally buildings of nice groomed parks would go, and it worked. The materials that we're using is four primary materials: iron, rocks, wood, and mirrors. We all have a personal relationship with those materials, whether we know it or not, and the proof is in the pudding. We have received a grant from the Kresge Foundation, a grant from the Knights Foundation, all kinds of media coverage from Elle Magazine, American Express, the New York Times, the Washington Post, and we were just featured in Art in America, which is, to me, is my pride this moment, because that is our trade publication. It's just too much to talk about in detail, so we decided to just have these images running of our space in the background. And I hope you enjoy it, but we have done a great job in bringing people together that normally would not come together. We have people coming to our facilities from China, Japan, Russia, Israel, Palestine, you name the country, they have visited our space. And there's a couple of people in this audience today that's visited our space. We have not advertised. It's the timing is right for the African to become part of the country, the conscience of people in America. And we are there to show that there is a demand and it will not be rejected, and people will not frighten people. We've been quite successful in our endeavor.
One of the things that's most remarkable about my experience with the African Bead Museum is how Dabls uses materials as a form of memorialization. The materials that he uses are all found objects, repurposed objects in particular from an era of a certain economic era in Detroit where blacks were diasporic Africans were achieving what some call this middle class lifestyle. But as industry left and as jobs left, then not only did it leave economic displacement, but it left a lot of physical displacement as well. And these artifacts, using them, repurposing them in murals and in amazing installations that span over three city blocks, all for the point of helping us get back in contact with ourselves and project new African futures.
Thank you.
So much. You know, we jury members don't have any more information than you do or we just saw. So it's really amazing images. I wanted to know a little more where this was happening. The neighborhood, who lives there, who owns the property, and maybe a sense of, you know, what was there before and what has changed in the way people are coming or being in the space. There are a lot of visitors, but I wondered who's there.
We own three row houses and an independent building that has four row houses, which is three stories high. We first just went renegade. The spaces in between those buildings was full of debris, we decided to clean the debris up and we start building installations. 14 years later, the city came to us and said that this has become an iconic site. We're just going to give you the land. So I said, okay, they're going to give us the land. Why don't we just continually use it without the gift? Because the gift has a tax associated with it. So the city has backed off, and the city came back again and said, we want to make this a historical site. Would you be in agreement with it? We would underwrite the cost of doing A, B, C, and D. The whole we're in the community, 2 miles from downtown, but any place you have a good product, a good service, people will come. That area now, we just kind of brought life to that area because anytime you have a place where people come to be, it makes the people in that area feel better about themselves. We've been there for 16 years, it's out in the open. We've had no vandalism, no issues with any of the neighbors. They welcome what we are doing because a brief moment of having art in your life is worth 3 or 4 years because it don't take a lifetime to be moved by art. And what we are doing is uplifting that community in particular. Our goal at first was to serve people from curbside. That was the vision. Just the people driving down the street would take an interest in what we were doing. There's an expressway behind us, and the state say at least 200,000 people travel that expressway a day, and they can't miss the installation.
So I think it's, you know, it's great what you're doing. I'm thrilled that you have a nice foundation grant. That was going to be one of my questions. But there are so many communities with empty spaces like this and with materials that can be repurposed, and just with a little bit of creativity, you can do something similar. So how do you think about kind of using your experience to spread that kind of creative redevelopment?
Well, it's already happening. Most people are copycat or inspired by others. There's at least four community who said they've taken items it's picked up off the street and placed them in Detroit and placed them on the wall, and it looked beautiful. So we are influencing and impacting more than the immediate community in what we are doing. But the goal was not to impact anyone else, it's just tell a good story ourselves.
Tell a good story about diasporic African people who happen to be the majority population in Detroit. Also want to name that Dabls has been invited to Highland Park neighborhood, has been invited to Eastern Market in Detroit to create space with his unique style of mural and installation, creating space for cultural identity to live where it's being violently erased.
Thank you.